A leaked email from the Ministry of Foreign Affairs and Trade shows Te Reo Māori has been removed from some official document templates. The ministry says they've made the adjustments while the country awaits for a new government. But the outgoing foreign minister had previously championed the official use of Te Reo.
And the values expressed in Te Reo was a great connector to where we wanted to forge new relationships. Through our culture, we had other kind of diplomatic tools to be able to create those relationship networks that we rely on. And so Te Reo is a part of that, but so too are our tikanga.
For more, Professor Ella Henry from Auckland University of Technology joins us this morning. Morena Ella, thank you so much for being with us this morning. Can you just decipher what the former Foreign Affairs Minister was actually saying? Then she said, through our culture we had other diplomatic tools to be able to create those relationship networks that we rely on. What did she mean?
I think that was being very politic, and obviously because she's worked alongside this man, she may have a different view of him than the public one we've been talking about. So that is quite a political statement. It's very generous, given the behaviour, and I think the tikanga speaks for itself. You know, we welcome all foreign dignitaries with porphyry, and many have expressed, you know, joy at being involved in something like that. So our culture is an intrinsic part of New Zealand identity. I think that's the meaning. And it doesn't matter whether or not the reo is used on briefing papers to incoming ministers, the culture is alive and well and vibrant.
Now, can we talk about the document, so to speak? We know that one official document template has been changed, and presumably that template can be used on more than one document, right? But we don't particularly know that. So what possible rationale could Chief Executive Chris See provide that could justify this approach?
There has been, right throughout the campaign, there have been parts of the incoming government representatives who've made it very clear they are not sympathetic towards Te Ao Māori, towards Te Reo Māori. Now, if those people are in prominent positions of power, if their parties are in prominent positions of power, we may be moving into a very negative era for Te Reo Māori. But
I'll just stop you there because Winston Peters has certainly made his feelings known, right? He would change all of the woke virtue signalling names of every government department back to English. And this was during his State of the Nation speech at the beginning of this year. So he certainly has made his feelings known about this.
Absolutely, and so has the leader of the ACT Party in terms of race-based privilege and race-based policies, and there's nothing more race-based than using Te Reo Māori as an introduction. So, I mean, at least two parties in the coming coalition have got some kind of negative attitude towards Te Reo Māori, but the reality is it does not matter what the government thinks about Te Reo Māori. The gate is open. You know, a growing number of New Zealanders of all ethnicities are embracing the language and appreciating it. I think there will be a lot of embarrassment in political circles that this document has been released early. I don't think it reflects well on the ministry or the CEO. And I think it's going to cause such an embarrassment for the incoming government, who are trying to sell themselves as a good, moderate leader of the country moving forward, that I think that this particular memo will be banished to a dark recess.
Now, Ella, we do have a statement from MFAT, and you won't be able to see this, but I'm going to read it out. And it says, the application of Te Reo Māori within the ministry and across communication channels remains unchanged. We have made an adjustment to one template during the caretaker period. The ministry will consult with the incoming minister for their preferences on receiving advice. Talk about hedging your bets, Ella. Is this what we should expect from the public service?
Well, let's be very clear. The public service ceased to exist in 1987 with the State Services Act, and they became servants of the state, not servants of the public. So this man is behaving like a servant of the state, trying to decipher what the state may want, and, as you said, hedging his bets. But I think it's not going to reflect well on his tenure moving forward.
Now, people might say, not a big deal, Ella. It's one template. That's all it is. And, you know, they're waiting on advice. But is this the beginning of changes like this, do you think?
I think it isn't a big deal in the grand scheme of things, but it is indicative of the fact that there are public servants, civil servants, however you want to name them, in the government, looking forward to this change, and the change is going to be about reducing the impact of te reo Māori, me ona tikanga, of Māori language and culture. And I think that that is a bad thing, given the gains that have been made in recent years.
We have spoken with Rawari Waititi, and this is what he had to say about this issue.
That CEO should now step down from that particular post, because he has shown that he has no respect for a treaty obligation, he has no respect for the Treaty of Waitangi, has no respect for tangata whenua, has no respect for our culture, has no respect for our language, and so he should step down from that position.
Yeah, no tiptoeing around the issue for Rawari Waititi, obviously asking for the CEO to stand down. How realistic is that, though, Ella?
I don't think it's realistic per se, but I love the fact that Te Pāti Māori have drawn a line in the sand of where they stand on these positions, and they will be loud and they will be vocal and they will represent the views of very many Māori. I actually think this man's job may be untenable moving forward, not because his department came up with this, but because somebody allowed it to leak inadvertently.
How big, and again, I want to go back to this, how big of an issue is this? I mean, it's big enough for us to be sitting here having a conversation about it, right? So again, we've got an incoming government coming in. So in the whole scheme of things, how big is this, Ella?
This government has taken a while to form. There are a number of people who are growing impatient. I think that they will want to be taking as much of a middle line as possible moving forward. They will want a transition to be smooth, to be as positive as it can be. And I think the last thing they want to be doing is angering the second largest ethnic group in the country.
Tēnei te mihi atu, kia koe, te marae kura. Thank you so much for being with us this morning. Professor Ella Henry joining us from AUT. Tēnā koe.
Tēnā mihi.